Welcome to JPlays. I am Iceman. This is part 10 of the Let's Play series going through System Shock 2. We're currently at the... just reached the body of a mini. After escaping in a... launching in an escape pod to Tau City. Before we go much further, you see the fleshy stuff on the walls and those bad textures. For a bit of disgusting info for you, what they used for the textures for this was taken from a colonoscopy of one of the game devs. So what you see around there, for example, comes directly from the photos taken from that.
The many hold sway here. Even I cannot maintain contact. You are on your own, human.
Fail me not.
Flying things dragged me and David here last night. I don't remember much about the trip. I guess I must have blocked it out, half conscious most of the time. I keep remembering the part from Pinocchio, you know, where the old man goes looking for the puppet inside the whale. Except I don't think anyone's coming in here to save me.
To spread yourself out on our warp.
One of our many will be there to help you before long.
Thank you.
there. Please make your selection. Hi there. Please make your selection. Thank you for choosing Value Wrap. Hi there. Please make your selection. Thank you for choosing Value Wrap. Hi there. Please make your selection.
That this many, as it calls itself, indeed has a centralized nervous system, which means it would have to have some kind of centralized control. To this end, I've gathered as many weapons as I could and stashed them in caches. One of the beasts discovered a cache and apparently mistook it for food. It simply brought it into the crunching room. Passageways are blocked by some kind of sphincter. I follow the nerves that threaded out of the walls from the blockage. They lead to a pair of nerve clusters. When the passageway is open, the cluster seems to contract. Conversely, I wonder if I was able to destroy both clusters, it would open the blockage permanently. I'm anxious to see the rest of this beast. Thank you.
Her coldness is not welcome within the warmth of our flesh.
Thank you.
Hi there. Please make your selection. Hi there. Please make your selection. Hi there. Please make your selection.
Reinitialized.
Chemical needed. Research complete. Thank you.
be right back in a few minutes.
There. Please make your selection. Thank you for choosing value wrap.
I have a choice.
closet.
Is that this place is just an absolute maze. Ah, there we go.
You tear our very flesh
with no thought of compassion.
Compassion.
do you think we will sit idly by?
While you corrupt the very womb of our existence.
You seek your associates, but you cannot find them.
You are so very alone. How does it feel
to be one
against the infinite?
Noise coming from the next area. It sounds like chewing. I think I know what's going to happen here. This is some kind of digestive tract of a very, very large animal. I go back and forth between being fascinated and terrified. The creature's a remarkable discovery. I wish I could only live long enough to learn more.
feel you moving inside of us.
The sensation is repulsive.
That's what she said.
Besides the parasitic behavior evidenced in the life cycle of the human-annelid hybrids, it's becoming clear to me that Shodan has bred the Many to use humans for other purposes. First of all, the Many clearly has the capability to convert human flesh to energy. It can eat us, but it can also directly use us in the creation of its egg pods. Corpses are fed into some kind of tubular structure, and eggs are birthed through a nearby tube. I've been unable to determine whether the organism is directly converting the corpses into egg structures or not. But it's clear that there's some connection between the nutrient pool we provide and the eggs that are being produced. Understand the annelid life cycle fully. It's clearly extremely diverse. The eggs produce either a male or a female spore. The male, the drones, are wasp-like creatures. The female are worm-like annelids that seek out a host to infect. Following infection, the host begins to transform into a human annelid hybrid. From that point, the life form can take numerous paths. I believe this path is determined by the Many itself. The creatures have communicated their need to grow the biomass. So I imagine that biological material is their primary resource. Therefore, each path has costs and benefits. The proto-arachnid is extremely quick and potentially relatively cheap in biomass. The hulking fleshy ones are powerful, but are clearly a larger investment. I've observed only one example of the floating organisms. The only comfort is that the more dangerous organisms are quite costly to produce, limiting their numbers.
Thank you.
is a womb where we grow our future.
Weapons fail. Your ammunition runs low.
And you've yet to see our most beautiful creation. All you have is your hatred and your individuality.
Now don't you wish you joined us? Would you then feel so alone?
Thank you.
Years of evolution. They've been able to conquer this starship, mankind's mightiest creation. Where were we after 40 years of evolution? What swamp were we swimming around in, single-celled and mindless? What if Shodan's creations are superior to us? What will they become in 1 million years, in 10 million years? What's clear is that Shodan shouldn't be allowed to play God. She's far too good at it. That this thing I'm trapped inside is intimately linked with all the organisms I observed on board the Von Braun. Strike that. This creature is the same organism. Perhaps the best way to describe it, or perhaps the only way I can comprehend it, is that the organism serves to perform the highest mental functions of the entire species. The smaller creatures exist only to enact its will. Now, strike that too. All the specimens act as a whole, like different organs in a single body. With this entity acting primarily as a brain. If one were to destroy this large specimen, I wonder, would it snuff out all the others?
Thank you.
Oh, fuck off.
I'm being taken away now. It's my turn. I'm being dragged into some kind of chamber. The ceiling is aligned with a number of panels. Wrestling with what appear to be stalactites or teeth. The creature's put me down now. He's leaving. I might have been spared. What's going on? It's dark in here. I can hear the moans of someone. Claudette? Is that you? I seem to have stepped into something soft, slippery. I'm starting to...
She is a stranger to everything we cherish.
Struggled, but I never had any intention of destroying the Von Braun.
The Von Braun's faster than light drive can be used to create pockets of
pockets of proto reality. I am now using it to modify reality to my own specifications.
The process shall not take long. If it sounds unpleasant to you, put your mind at ease, insect. You will not survive to see my new world order.
Just before we finish this video, what Shodan is doing there is using the FTL drive to change reality to her liking. And as you'll see in the ending, what she wants to do is send herself off to all possible parallel universes. There was a series of fan fictions, the Darkseid Chronicles, that went into that side of things, which go off into, for example, Shodan sending herself into the land of Fallout, and Star Wars, and several other ones. And my campaign that I did for, or am doing for, Shadowrun Returns goes into a possible parallel of that, where Shodan is sent to the Shadowrun universe. Anyways. So that finishes it for this video of the Body of the Mini section. One last video to go after this, and then it is done, this series. That one, next one, will be out shortly. See you soon.